Hello everyone, in today's episode I would like to discuss the topic of drug treatments for persistent postural perceptual dizziness PPPD. In a recent episode of the Practical Neuro-otology series, I talked about McMillan's approach to treating this condition. But can we use medications to manage PPPD? Yes, according to the recommendations of the Barany Society, the International Society for Neuro-otology, Vestibular Medicine and Vestibular Research, medications can be part of an overall therapy plan for PPPD. Through my conversations with patients suffering from this condition, I have found that many of them use various medications, not only those strictly recommended by the Barany Society, but also others beyond those guidelines. How do drugs affect patients? After many discussions with patients undergoing treatment for their PPPD, I categorize them into four groups. The first group of patients benefits from using medications even if the improvement is only 10%. Any improvement is still a positive outcome, not to mention those who experience even greater benefits. What is most important is that they do not experience any side effects from the drugs. This group consistently has the most favorable outcomes. The second group of patients includes those who benefit from using medications during the treatment of PPPD, although to varying degrees. Unfortunately, the side effects of the medications do occur. The impact of these side effects depends on their nature and severity. Even mild side effects that are not dangerous and are tolerable for the patient must be considered in relation to the benefits of the medication. If the advantages of the drugs outweigh the side effects, the patient can continue treatment. However, if the side effects become overwhelming, it is necessary to discontinue the use of the medication. The third group of the patients includes individuals who do not experience any benefits from using medications but also do not suffer from any side effects. This is considered a neutral group. In this case, continuing the use of the current medication is unnecessary and it may be worthwhile to consider alternative drugs. The fourth group has it the worst. They not only do not experience any benefits from using drugs, but they also suffer from various side effects. In this case, the discontinuation of drug use is immediately necessary. When it comes to treating persistent postural perceptual dizziness PPPD, we often face uncertainty regarding how a patient will respond to the medication. Unfortunately, we can't predict which category of treatment a patient will fall into or how they will react to specific drugs. Currently, there is no universally effective medication for PPPD that comes without potential side effects. If a particular drug works for one patient, it doesn't guarantee that it will be effective for another. Finding the right medication is highly individual and may differ greatly from person to person. Additionally, based on extensive discussions with PPPD patients, I've learned that medications are typically a part of a broader treatment plan rather than the sole solution for managing PPPD. In any case, before using any medication for your PPPD, consult your doctor first. Thank you for watching, take care and stay informed.